Hi guys, welcome back to Switch Up. Big thanks to all the new subscribers we've had. I think we did almost 1,000 subscribers in a couple of days this week, which is incredible, and we really do appreciate it. Be sure to leave a comment down below. I think I can genuinely say this might be one of the best weeks in a while. So, let's get on with the list. First up then, we've got Mega Man Zero and ZX Legacy Collection, which drops on the 25th. This brings together six of the classic titles. You've got Mega Man Zero, 2, 3, 4, Mega Man ZX, and ZX Advent. Just as we've seen with some of these other classics remade, or at least re-released, they've included a slightly different mode on each called the Z Chaser mode, as well as a casual mode and save assist features. Whether or not you like that, well, that's up to you. This one's about 24 quid. Then we've got one from Glenn's favourite genre, that's Samurai Showdown from Koch Media, which drops on the same day. There are 16 characters from the series here, and it takes place a year before the events of the original Samurai Showdown game. For those unfamiliar with the original title, these are fighters that have a heavy emphasis on the weapons that the characters have, and using those alongside the original mechanics such as the Rage Gauge, Rage Explosion, Sword Clash, and others is what makes this such a tactical fighting experience. It's quite expensive at £44.99, but I believe this can also be had physically. Shido. Next up then, and needing no introduction really, is Two Point Hospital from Sega. This is essentially the spiritual successor to Theme Hospital. Patients are reminded to be patient. An amazing, amazing game. Glenn's just reviewed it, he absolutely loved it. I think he gave it 87%. There is a real childish delight from people coming in with Yeti disease and having to build the correct machines to solve and cure their various ailments. An amazing title, well, a very good one at least, based on an amazing title, and it looks to have lived up to its predecessor. This drops on the 25th.
Shoes in our capable hands. We're building a brighter, safer future, and hardly anything will stand in our way. You deserve the best. So join us at Two Point Hospital. We're open for new staff, new patients, and a new you. Can I go play golf yet? I'm teeing off at 3.
Next up is a really interesting tactical RPG called Broken Lines from Super.com. So this story-driven tactical adventure is set within a alternate history version of World War II, which is interesting in itself. It very much focuses on the stories of 8 different soldiers who have crash-landed behind enemy lines. Wouldn't it be nice if this was something like Commandos? What a great series that was. There are a number of different endings throughout the game, and apparently the choices you make will affect those. And the interesting little twist, as is so often the case, here your decisions will also affect the entire region. So different regions in the game will be affected by the choices you make. And if you make the wrong ones, then the soldiers you're controlling are gonna let you know. It's an 18 rating, so this could potentially have quite adult themes, which actually I quite like seeing on the Nintendo Switch. This drops on the 25th.
Watch out! Ouch.
Then onto a game I am definitely going to be picking up. It's called Edgar Bok Bokin Balzac. Edgar Bok Bokin Balzac. That's Balzac, not Balzac. And that's from La Poule Noire. Now this looks like a lovely little adventure title. It really does have a lovely striking style. In fact, it's almost somewhere between Day of the Tentacle and Old Man's Journey that Glenn reviewed. The story goes that the crackpot outcast Edgar sets out to Balzac to save his squash and instead uncovers an unearthly secret at the heart of the city. A colourful, surreal and utterly bonkers narrative adventure. Well, sign me up, this looks delightful. It seems reasonably priced at around about £14 and it drops on the 26th.
If chaos came to strike, if their lives were threatened, or worse, if squashes ran out, only one.
Then we've got Kingdom Rush Frontiers. Now, if you've heard, well, you would have heard probably of the Kingdom Rush series from mobile and other places, but Ironhide Games Studio are bringing it over to the Switch, and these are really very addictive tower defense games. There are 60 different enemies, each with their own unique abilities, as well as 16 legendary heroes, and you'll be choosing different champions and training up their abilities throughout the game. It's nice that they've included the achievements, so there are 80 different achievements to unlock. If only Nintendo would get on that. It's one of my biggest things I miss from back on the Xbox. And overall, it's quite a charming game. I've been playing a little bit of this one actually, and it seems quite decent. It drops on the 27th. Then we've got Heaven Dust from Indie Nova, and this could be the nice little cheeky budget choice for next week. It's launching with a pre-order discount actually that will take it down to £5, which is could be a bit of a bargain. And it's a love letter to classic 90s survival horror games. If you remember back from the list last week, go and check it out if you didn't see it. There was another love letter to classic 90s survival horror games, but I wouldn't really call it a letter, it was more of a death threat. It looked awful. This looks really nice. It's got a cutesy top-down 3D style. And for that price, can it really be that bad? Well, the answer is yes, it can be, but hopefully we'll be able to let you know. This one drops on the 27th. The next one gets in just on its name alone, and that's Boulder Dash, the 30th anniversary from BBG Entertainment. Yes, I remember playing so much of the original game way back in the day. There are 280 plus levels, over 12 different worlds, so that is impressive. You can fully customize the look of your character and as well as their abilities. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the original, it was created by, I believe, Peter Leeper, and that was exactly, well, around about 30 years ago. I think it was 1984. My goodness. It looks like they've really put a lot of love and attention into the amount that's gone into this game. But what I will say is it's a shame they haven't gone so far as to introduce any form of multiplayer. It is quite cheap, around about £13, and it drops on the 27th. Then there's Underhero from Digirati. I'm pretty sure we talked about this a couple of weeks back, so perhaps it was delayed, I'm not really sure. But if you don't remember, this one's essentially where you play as the underling. So the real hero dies, and then you have to take over his role. It's a side-scrolling RPG adventure, but interestingly has turn-based combat. I thought this looked good when I first saw it, and I still think it looks good. This drops on the 27th, and it's around £15. Then as you reach the tail end of the week, you've got Rune Factory 4, the special edition from Marvelous Europe, which we definitely didn't accidentally release our review of for a few hours. And we'll have a review of that one, hopefully. This is obviously a very well thought of and highly regarded series, and it's nice to have the special edition come to the Nintendo Switch. It drops on the 28th. It's around about £32. And you'll be surprised to hear we've got a review of that one coming. Yeah. On that same day, you've also got the Metro 2033 Redux and the Metro Last Light Redux. I have been playing these to death, and my goodness, am I allowed to say they've done a great job? Look, they've done a great job. If they want to get annoyed at me for saying that, well, it's happened now. Our full review of that one will be out on Tuesday, I believe, so keep your eye out for that one. The last game I want to mention is, very briefly, is a one called Blood Roots, and it's described on the eShop as an action arcade platform adventure game. And it caught my attention just with this line here. It says, "It's a relentless action game that unfolds across the sprawling Weird West. You'll choreograph spectacular ultra-violent combos by making use of everything around you, from hatchets to ladders to carrots." So yeah, I can't really tell you exactly what this is, if it's almost like a murder sandbox, but there's a real heavy emphasis on everything in the world being able to be used as a weapon, and that each level will require you to do this to overcome all of the enemies. It's a lovely visual style as well, and yeah, I don't know, this could be a little bit of a sleeper hit. This one's £14, and it also drops at the end of the week. So that's it for this week. I do want to just shout out a few names that have caught my eye. There's games like Profane, Bucket Knight, Stab Stab Stab, Be a Walker, I mean, being a mech walker, that is awesome, Wanderlust from Sometimes You, and Mousecraft. There are good games coming this week. I think this could genuinely be one where you have to part with some cash. Let me know down in the comments which of these you enjoyed, and remember, for all things Switch, all the time, keep it Switch up. Cheers guys, see ya!